Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. So I'm going to show you today how to get a collection of ninth chords working for you in the style of funk. These chord patterns add the ninth interval onto minor and dominant chords for a sound that's simple and beautiful. The chord shapes will be covered first, and then I'll show you a couple of ways that you can apply these chords into your guitar routine. Now this video will help you learn the chord patterns and a couple of riffs to get you working these shapes on a funky chord jam, and the second half of this lesson, which will be posted on my Patreon page, will cover the breakdown of the music theory behind ninth chords. You're not going to want to miss that. It's excellent to understand that information. Plus, on top of all that, I'm going to give you an example piece that applies the sound of the ninth chord shapes that we will cover here in the lesson. Before we get started, I just want to let you in on how you can get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the CreativeGuitarStudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to CreativeGuitarStudio.com/donations. To donate and download your copy today. The ninth chord shapes that I have for you include the most common ones that get used in funk, and they're a part of the minor and the dominant chord qualities. Sometimes you may also find major nine chords in funk, but you know, it's more likely that minor and dominants are going to tend to be the most common. And because we're keeping things simple and we're just going for the most basic shapes in this lesson, we're going to focus on the root, fourth, and fifth chords off of an A. So that means we're going to have chord roots of A, D, and E. The first shape that I have for you, this is a really straightforward shape. You could play it like that or like that. You'll probably find that your small finger is going to be best up top, so I'm going to kind of dictate it that way. So I'm just barring with my first finger, covering all three of those strings there from fourth to third to second. Small fingers up top on that chord shape right there. So that's an A minor 9. You could also include the open fifth string if you want to fatten it up in the bass a little bit. Sounds really nice like that, actually, but it's up to you. The next shape I have for you is dominant 9, and this is off of a D root on the 5th fret of the 5th string. You can tell here I'm laying flat with my 3rd finger to catch the top 3 strings. And I've got also this F sharp note right there on the 4th fret of the 4th string with my index finger. All right, so there's a 4th position, 5th string root D, dominant 9. Now, the last one I got for you is based off the E, and it's set up right here on the 7th fret E on 5th string. And this is a really nice one. It's very warm sounding. It's a really beautiful, kind of a thick, gentle, though, sounding chord. Really nice sound. And we're getting the chord's minor 3rd over here on the 4th string, 5th fret. And then the ring finger and small finger are just up on 3rd and 2nd string on the 7th fret there, catching those tones. So it's a bit of a stretch, not much of one though, but you do have to make a bit of a reach there with the index finger from the middle finger on the 5th string to 4th string. Now, what I would suggest doing as a practice routine with this is to practice going from the A minor 9 into the D dominant 9, and then head back again to that root chord once more. Then that 5 chord, the E minor 9. And you can create just a simple movement of chord changes to get things started. So that'll be a great way to start practicing these shapes. It doesn't take a lot of effort, but it will be a little bit of a routine that you're going to have to get down before all three of these chords feel comfortable. Chord application is always one of the absolute best ways to help integrate the use of any new chord shape that enters into your practice routine. Now, these minor and dominant ninth chords are both great chord sounds when it comes to performing in the funk style. And the way that I've set them up here to help you integrate these is it's going to be through the use of a funk guitar rhythm riff that incorporates chord shots along with single note lines. Here's how it sounds. Thank you. All right, so we're dealing with a chord progression here that's in the E minor tonality, with our root chord being E minor 9. We head to the fourth chord off that E, which is A minor 9. And then we're also going to have the seventh chord off of that root of E, which will be D dominant 9. All right, so those are the three chords we're going to be utilizing. There are some passing licks that we're playing in between, so we've got some licks around these chords. When we start things off on the E minor 9, it's a nice smooth strumming on 16th notes. The way you're going to best achieve that is with a light grip of your guitar pick, and that way the pick will float over your strings very easily. If you grip the pick too hard, it's going to be really difficult for that pick to float over those strings and create that nice smooth 16th note strumming effect. All right, so it's all in the grip of that pick to get that nice sound. After that strum on the E minor 9 chord, we're going to move into a guitar lick that's based off 4th string, 7 to 9. And then we're going to move to 3rd string, getting 7, 7, and then 7 to 9 at the end there to finish that measure off. You can decide what your favorite picking directions will be on that. I like doing a lot of up picking on that. I think it just sounds really smooth that way. And then we go back to the E minor 9 chord, so we have the 16th notes there again. New guitar lick, though, at this point, we have a 7 to 9 slide, and then some nice even 8th notes going 8, 10, 7, 8 between the 2nd to the 1st and 2nd strings. So, just like that. All right, so the first two measures, once again, goes like this. All right, after that, we move into the A minor 9 chord. Notice there's a little bit of a difference to the groove now, and it just changes things up. It's more laid back now. All right, remember that, you know, real light grip of the guitar pick to get you nice, smooth strum attacks. Okay, so we're just working out that A minor 9 there, and then we're going to move over to D dominant 9 next. Same kind of feel on the strums, but we do have a turnaround lick that takes place from the 5th string. It's a really simple 5 and 7 on the frets between 5th string and 4th string. So you put it all together and you got the second line going like this. All right, so now that you have some type of an example idea that is operating with these sounds of the 9 chord on minor as well as the dominant, you can go to work and start, you know, integrating this into your own playing. I'm sure you'll easily find some cool spots in pieces that you know, or maybe some stuff that you can just write, you know, come up with off the cuff and integrate these sounds, because these chords have such a great effect and they really do sit so well in the world and the style of funk. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video where I'm going to break down the music theory behind ninth chords. We'll cover minor, major, and dominant. I'll explain everything in that lesson. On top of that, I'm going to have an example piece for you that applies the sound of ninth chords. It's the piece that you heard me play at the very beginning of this YouTube lesson. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you're going to get a jam track, and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all of the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lesson. So head over to my Patreon and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.